Let's begin to bless the name of the Lord this morning because He's good, for His mercies endureth forever. Adore His name for giving us a gift of a new week. We are bright this morning because of the grace of God. We're looking radiant this morning because of His mercy. Adore His name this morning. He's the way maker. He's the Almighty Father. He's the King of all kings. He's the Lord of all lords. There's none before Him, and there's none who comes after Him. He's the all in. He's our all in all. Let's worship Him. Let's worship Him. Let's adore Him. You are the King of all glory. Daddy, we bless Your name, for You are a way maker. We thank You for the gift of a new week. We thank You for the things You've planned to do for us this week. We thank You because we know that You're going before us to make every crooked way straight this week. We thank You for every promise that will begin to come to pass this week. We thank You for miracles that we're about to see this week. We give You all the glory. We give You all the honor. There's none like You. Thank You, glorious Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Psalm 100 verse 2 says, serve the Lord with gladness and come before His presence with singing. Begin to worship Him this morning. This is what we've been asked to do. We've been asked to come before Him, come to His presence with singing. Let's begin to sing a melody in our heart this morning. Daddy, I bless Your name, the Prince of all princes. Oh, my soul to Kashanda, we bless You, we adore You, we worship Your name. Oh Lord, Daddy, even if no one is praising You, I'm here to say thank You, Jesus. Thank You for Your love. Thank You for Your grace. Thank You for Your abundance wealth over my life. Thank You for open doors, oh Lord. Daddy, we bless Your holy name. Say, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Daddy, I bless You because I've got breath in Him. Me, and I'm here to praise You this morning. Thank You, Master Jesus. Thank You, glorious God. Thank You, Lily of the Valley. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have worshipped. Amen. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have worshipped. Amen. If you are watching me on Facebook, please share with your friends and families. As you do so, may you be richly blessed in the name of Jesus. Amen. This morning, I quickly want to talk to you about there will be an end. There will be an end. This, the Bible says in the book of Proverbs 26 verse 18, it says, for surely there will be a latter end. Hallelujah. It said, a future and a reward, and your hope and expectation shall not be cut off. This is God saying to you this morning, no matter what you're going through, we all face situations that look permanent in our lives, in our health, in our relationships, in our career. It looks as if nothing will change. But the good news this morning is God is saying to you and I, He says, surely there will be an end in the name of Jesus. No matter how bad that situation may look like, no matter how difficult, I don't know what your doctor has told you. They've told you you will never get well. But God is saying this morning, there will be an end. You know, it is so easy for us to think, oh, this is the way it's just going to be. My health is just going to be in this form. My relationship will never work out. You know, the devil plants that seed in us. But God is saying to us, everything, every difficulty you're going through will come to end in the name of Jesus. You know, I want you to stay positive no matter what you're going through. Don't stay negative. Don't say to yourself, oh, this struggle, I will always struggle with this disease. I will always have a breakup in my relationship. I will never get a good job. You know, I will always remain on this level. This is not what God wants to hear from you. He's sending a message to you through me today, and He sent me to tell you there will be an end in the name of Jesus. He said your future, your reward, He said your hope and expectation will not be cut off. I don't know what you are expecting, especially this week. I don't know what you are praying for. God is saying to you, it will not be cut off. For every problem, every difficulty is coming to an end at this season in the name of Jesus. Just because that situation looks permanent doesn't mean He has come to stay. Doesn't mean it's permanent to God. The one who created you, He knows what you're going through. He wouldn't have allowed that problem to come by if He doesn't have a solution to it. Even before you encounter that problem, the solution is being supplied by God. So I just want you to have faith in God, believe in God. Your situation hasn't come to stay forever. It's just going to pass by. There will always be an end. That end date, you know, it's been written by God. The expiry date to your problem, to your situation, is being written by God. So I want you to stay in faith today. Believe it that every problem I see today is coming to an end. My health issue is coming to an end. Difficulties in life, you know, difficulties at your place of work, those challenges are coming to an end. Don't celebrate them. Don't celebrate them. Believe it. You are walking out of it in the name of Jesus. And do you know what? Every expectation you have today will come to pass. It will never be cut short in the name of Jesus. Maybe you are the type that you're not expecting anything anymore. You've tried for so long, nothing works. It's as if God is not answering your prayer. This is the time for you to start expecting again. This is the time for you to start believing again. This is the time for you to start dreaming again. For you will see those dreams coming to pass in the name of Jesus. God knew you. He knew that trouble even before he came to your life. He knew you were going to go through what you're going through today. And do you know what? He's got a plan for it. He's got an expiring date for it. He's got an end date for you. All you just need to do is just to rejoice in the Lord. All you need to do is just to put your faith into action, and you'll see God moving in your life in the name of Jesus. He said, we're serving a God who is the Alpha and Omega. He knows the end from the beginning. He created you, but he knows how your end is going to look like. We live our life day by day. We don't know what happens tomorrow, but God knows. We don't know what will happen to us next year, but God knows. And God is saying to you today, there's an end to those disadvantages in the name of Jesus. He said there's an end to those breakup in the name of Jesus. There's an end to those lack in the name of Jesus. If you can just agree with me this morning, if you can just believe with me this morning, you will see it coming to pass in the name of Jesus. You are walking out of those difficulties in the name of Jesus. They haven't come to stay forever. They haven't come to stay. That expiring date, I don't know if you can see it. I can see it right now. God has written it out. Start believing it again. Start believing God is taking you to a higher ground in the name of Jesus. You know, those difficulties may look as if, oh, they're not going to change, you know. You've tried so long, your bank account, you never have a good amount of money in your bank account, and you're thinking you'll ever be a failure, you'll ever be a pauper. But God is saying to you, there will be an end in the name of Jesus. That sickness is coming to an end. That chronic pain is coming to an end. That loneliness is coming to an end. That debt, that addiction is coming to an end. All your trouble will not last forever. They didn't come to stay. They just come to pass away. God is bringing an end to it in the name of Jesus. God had already made a way out for you. Even if you can't see this morning, but God has made it. God had already made a plan on how you're going to walk out of that trouble. Just believe in God. Rely on God. They depend on God. For they just hear. Just for a moment. It's just a matter of time. You will soon experience your healing again in the name of Jesus. You will soon experience your abundance in the name of Jesus. You will soon experience your restoration in the name of Jesus. You will soon experience your new level in the name of Jesus. You are experiencing your breakthrough in the name of Jesus. The scripture says something profound in the book of Job 28 verse 3. It said, God has set an end to darkness. God has set an end to the trouble. God is talking to you this morning. God has set an end to your darkness. God has set an end to your trouble. These are not my words. These are the word of God. This word is coming to you this morning. There's an end to those troubles in the name of Jesus. The God we are serving is the Alpha and Omega, is the beginning and the ending. He has a way out for you. He has set an end to that sickness. He has set an end to that addiction. Maybe you're going through it this moment and you're thinking you'll never do away with this addiction. The good news is God has set an end for it. He set an end for that trouble in the name of Jesus. That loneliness is coming to an end. That injustice at work is coming to an end in the name of Jesus. You know what? That end, I know, is coming. It might be coming today. You might see it today. You might see it tomorrow. You might even see it this month. But what I know is that the word of God will be established over your life in the name of Jesus. You know, when your mind tells you it's not going to change, nothing is happening in my life, it's just going to remain like this forever, you've got to remind yourself that God has set an end to that trouble. You've got to remind yourself that God has set an end to that loneliness. You've got to remind yourself that God is bringing someone great, the perfect person. God is bringing it to your life in the name of Jesus. You've got to remind yourself that God has set an end to this lack. You know that promotion will be yours. You're gonna live in increase. You're gonna live in abundance in the name of Jesus. You're gonna lend to nation. You'll never be a borrower no more. Your situation right now is just here for, it's just temporal. God has set an end to it in the name of Jesus. This illness will not cost you your life. I'm telling you this morning. It won't cost you your life because the end date has been released by God. The end date has been set by God. The King of Kings, the one who spoke words into existence, the one who created you, the one who created the heaven and earth, is saying to you this morning, I've decided the end date. And you will see it. You will get healed in the name of Jesus. God had already set the end date to your trouble. So what you are going through today, just go through it by rejoicing, by thanking God and say, I know this will soon come to an end in the name of Jesus. I know I might be in trouble today, but I will soon start to enjoy in the name of Jesus. I know I might be in lack today, but I will soon have abundance. I will lend to nation. I will not borrow. This is the promise of God for my life. No. I may be lonely today, but God is sending the right people to me in the name of Jesus. Just stay in faith, begin to speak goodness, begin to speak positivity into your life, and you will see it coming to pass in the name of Jesus. One thing I know for sure is that the word of God is true. He said, I respect my words even more than my name. If God is saying to you today, he says, surely there will be an end. And I declare it over your life, there will be an end to that sorrow in the name of Jesus. There will be an end to that backwardness in the name of Jesus. There will be an end to that demotion in the name of Jesus. God had already set an end date to your trouble. Believe it. Your change is coming. Your time is coming. Your freedom is coming in the name of Jesus. You know, there was a time I met a guy who was in bondage, and he messaged me, told me about his situation. You know, it was as if he was working and someone else was collecting his salary. You know, for you to live in this country and you are just working for others to eat. It's been like that for years. And I prayed with him and I told him to relocate. And that point he relocated. That was the point of his breakthrough. Right now he's got his job. He's enjoying his life. He's earning more than even most of us. This is what God can do. If God is saying that change is coming, nobody can stop it. If God is saying this is the end, nobody can stop it. You know, what God did for him, God put an end to his trouble. God put an end to his bondage. And God is about to do the same to you this morning in the name of Jesus. If you can stay in faith, if you can believe God like it, if you can get to a point and say, and not be moved by your situation. Don't be moved, no matter how bad it is. Don't be moved by it, because you know God has set an end date to it in the name of Jesus. You know, it's going to get to a point in your life. You know, you've been struggling for so long. You've been in trouble for so long. The creator of the universe is going to say, enough is enough. This is my daughter. Enough is enough. This is my son. I didn't create her to be in sickness. I didn't create her to struggle. I didn't create her to be in trouble. This is your time. Your time has come. I've created you to live in victory. In the name of Jesus, I created you to live a victorious life. I created you to be free, enjoying your life. I created you to lend to nations and not to borrow. I created you to live this life to its fullness. And that time is now, in the name of Jesus. God may have allowed it. But do you know what? He has the power to put an end to it in the name of Jesus. And that end is now in the name of Jesus. God had already put an end to your struggles. In the name of Jesus, he's put an end to your problems. In the name of Jesus, God has put an end to your family situation. In the name of Jesus, God has put an end to your struggle. You've been struggling all your life and you think it's going to be like that for so long. But God is saying to you, I have the end date. Just relax. Just enjoy your life. I have the end date, and that end is coming to pass right now in the name of Jesus. You don't know it, but God knows it. He knows that date. He has it by hand, and you're walking through it in the name of Jesus. I don't know. It might be today. That end of your trouble might be today. It might be this week. It might be this month. It might be this year. But one thing I know, if you can stay in faith, if you can rely so much on God, you won't miss it. In the name of Jesus, just believe. As you wake up this morning, put a smile on your face. Let people know that you're not even bothered by your problem. Let people know that your troubles does not bother you. Just say, I'm a child of God. His plans for me, you know, are big. His plans for me is to give me an expected end. His plan for me is to make me rejoice in life. His plan for me is to give me a victorious life. If you can have this kind of attitude, you'll see God moving on your behalf. In the name of Jesus, you'll see God doing the things you can't do all by yourself. In the name of Jesus, you'll see God supporting you in everything you go through. In the name of Jesus, you might be lonely today and you're thinking you'll never meet the right person. God is saying to you, just relax. I'm bringing your perfect match in the name of Jesus. You might be dealing with sicknesses this morning and you're thinking you'll never get well. God is saying to you, there will be an end in the name of Jesus. For this is your season, for this is your hour. Everything you're praying for, I'm bringing it to pass. At the right time, everything you've been waiting for, I'm bringing them to pass even at the right time. Just rely so much on God. Rely so much on God. You know, when people ask you this week, they see you smiling and they ask you, oh, are you still lonely? Tell them, yes, I'm still lonely. I don't have a partner yet, but I know one thing. God is bringing the right person. God is walking behind the scene right now. He's bringing the right person to me. They ask you, oh, are you still in debt? Do you still have a lot to pay the bank? Don't lie about your situation. Tell them yes. But you know what? God is about to shift me. God is about to change my level. I will begin to lend to the nation. In the name of Jesus, I will never borrow. In the name of Jesus. They ask you about the illness. You said, do you know what? I still have it, but God is healing me. In the name of Jesus, you need to stay positive in life. You need to stay in faith. He said, without faith, it is impossible to please God. If you actually want to please God, you've got to have faith. Have faith. He said, if you can have faith as tiny as a mustard seed, you will speak to that mountain to move from there to there. So what God requires from you today is your faith. He doesn't need more. It needs your faith, and you will see God doing the impossible in your life in the name of Jesus. I pray for you today, sooner or later, you will change that job in the name of Jesus. Maybe you've been praying for God for a change of job. I'm prophesying into your lives today as an oracle of the Most High God. You are changing that job in the name of Jesus. God will give you a brand new job, a better position, with a better complaint in the name of Jesus. With a better income in the name of Jesus. God will open doors that no man can shut unto you in the name of Jesus. You've got to get in agreement with God. You've got to listen to what God is saying to you today. You've got to believe him. God is saying, where you are right now is not where you're staying forever. God is saying, I'm bringing you out of this drought into abundance in the name of Jesus. God is saying to you, I'm bringing you out of this fear. I'm bringing you out of this worry into peace in the name of Jesus. God is saying to you this morning, I'm bringing you out of this depression into joy in the name of Jesus. God is saying to you, I'm bringing you out of this struggle into what? Into the grace of God, into the favor of the Most High God in the name of Jesus. You may not see right now. You don't even know how it's going to happen, but just believe in God. Just know that the end date is already been set. Just know there's going to be an end. You know, David put it like this in Psalm 23, verse 4. He said, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil. Not this. David didn't say, though I live in the valley. He didn't say that. He said, though I walk through the valley. So what you're going through right now, you're walking through it. That's not your home. That trouble is not where you belong. You're walking through it like David. Amen. Many of us, we've settled for, we're just so comfortable with our situation. You think, oh, it's okay. I don't want to struggle in life. You know, we pack our bags and put it there. That valley is not your own. You are walking through it. In the name of Jesus, the end date has been set. That valley is temporary. It's not meant to be a permanent. It's meant to come to pass. And go to pass. You are meant to pass through it. You are meant to walk through it like David. And I see God taking you to your destination in the name of Jesus. If you're thinking this morning that this valley is your permanent place, you will never get to your destination. You will never get to your destiny. But God is saying to you this morning, have the attitude of David. Believe that you're passing through this valley. Believe it. Every one of us, even me, myself, we go through issues in life. At times we go through health issues. At times we go through lack. We go through financial difficulties, struggles at work. Too often we settle in that valley. We celebrate that valley by talking about it all the time. People see it written all over us. We are so downcasted. We've got to, you know, many of us, we've built our house in that valley. But God is saying to you this morning, I'm asking you like David, that pack your belongings. This, even today, pack your belongings and get out of that valley. For that is not your home. You are not meant to be there forever. You are meant to pass through it. You are meant to just see what is going on. It might be for 1 year. That trouble might be for 1 year. That health issue might be for 1 year. Might be for 2 years. But you know this is not my home. I'm packing my bag. I'm just walking through it. For the end date has been set. You are not a citizen of that valley. Amen? You are an illegal immigrant in that valley. You've got to move out this morning. You've got to move out by faith. You are not a citizen to loneliness. At all. You are not a citizen of addiction. You are not a citizen of that sickness. You are not a citizen of that struggle. It's just here for a little time. You've been here for more than 30 years and you've only been ill for 2 years and you're thinking it's going to stay forever. It's going to pass and go. Amen. You're just passing through it. You've got to make up your mind today. You've got to be determined today. I'm walking out of it by the strength of God. In the name of Jesus, this is my season. This is my hour. I believe it and I accept it that the end date has been set. In the name of Jesus. I see what God is doing right now. I believe what God is doing right now. I believe God is building me up. I believe God is making me a better person. I go through what I'm going through this day because God is making me stronger. It's just a process for me to get to my next level. In the name of Jesus, I'm not settling in this valley. I'm not building my house in this valley. I'm just passing through here. In the name of Jesus, I'm passing through this sickness right now. I'm passing through this disadvantage right now. I'm walking out. I'm getting out of this stronger. For the end date is being set. In the name of Jesus. You know, you may have a valley of lack in your life. You may have a valley of financial struggles right now. You may have a valley of loneliness right now. You will soon move out of it in the name of Jesus. I want you to get ready. I speak to you as a child of the Most High God this morning. Get ready. You are moving into abundance in the name of Jesus. You are moving into overflow in the name of Jesus. You are moving into more than enough. Do you know why? Because you are serving a more than enough God. You are not meant to struggle. You are not meant to live in lack. Don't build your house in that valley. You've got to move on by faith this morning. Believe what God is doing. Believe in the power of his righteousness. Believe he created you and he hasn't created you to suffer. You are just suffering just for a little time. You're just passing through the valley. You're sooner or later, you are moving out and you are getting into your destination in the name of Jesus. You know, you may be in the valley of loneliness right now and you're thinking, Hadassah, I've tried so hard. I've tried so many relationships, nothing works out. It's because God hasn't brought that perfect person. But you know what? Stay encouraged. Believe God. The end date has been set. The end date to that loneliness is being set. Your divine connection is happening right now. I see it happening in the name of Jesus. I see new friendship in the name of Jesus. Sooner or later, you are meeting that right person in the name of Jesus. You might be in the valley of struggle right now and you're thinking, oh, I'm going to struggle all my life. I don't want you to be discouraged. I want you to stay encouraged this morning and believe it. God is giving you beauty for your ashes in the name of Jesus. God will give you twice of what you had before in the name of Jesus. God will pay you back. Hallelujah. I'm repeating myself this morning. God will pay you back. Look at the life of Job. He lost everything that he had, but God paid him back. That God is still alive and is saying to you this morning, I know what you're going through. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. I'm ready to pay you back in the name of Jesus. You are not supposed to stay in that valley. You are not supposed to stay there. Your joy is here. We are in the morning right now. You are in the season of joy in the name of Jesus. God is saying to you, I'm giving you a brand new beginning. People will see it and they will ask you why. How did it happen? God is giving you a brand new beginning in the name of Jesus. You know, don't get stuck in this valley. Don't lose hope. Don't lose hope. Don't lose hope because of that disappointment. Don't lose hope because of that loss. Don't lose hope because of that heartbreak. God is saying to you, stay in faith, for you will soon see the end. I've set the end date. You will soon see the end. God has your name tattooed on his palm. You know what? God is taking away your tears and is giving you joy unspeakable. God is strengthening you in this, even at this moment, in the name of Jesus. You have the strength you need for every situation in the name of Jesus. You know, the same thing in the book of Genesis 15, God told Abraham, he said, I'm sending your people, I mean the Israelites, to a foreign land to be slaves for 400 years. He said, but they will get out, they will come out with great substance. You know what is so profound here is that God was the one who sent them into a slavery for 400 years. God allowed it to happen. But he said, I will bring them out with great substance. That means the things they never had, by the time they are coming out from that slavery, they will have it. The things they never had, by the time they are coming out of that difficulty, they will have it. You know, God, maybe your setback right now, one thing I know is God have allowed it. He had allowed it. But he's saying this morning, you are coming out with great substances in the name of Jesus. You are coming out with more than enough in the name of Jesus. Don't feel disappointed. Oh, don't feel, oh my God, God has forgotten me. God is saying to you, I allowed it. And I wouldn't have allowed it if I didn't have a way out. I know the way out. You are coming out with great substances. You are coming out with greater joy in the name of Jesus. You are coming out with greater peace in the name of Jesus. You are coming out with abundance in the name of Jesus. You know, Psalm 63 verse 12 says, we went through fire. We went through water, but you brought us out into a wealthy place. You are going through fire this morning. You are going through water this morning, but God is bringing you out. And it's not just bringing you out. It's bringing you out into a wealthy place in the name of Jesus. You may be in flood right now. You may be in fire right now. It doesn't actually concern me. But because I know God is bringing you out into a wealthy place in the name of Jesus. This is your season. to step into that wealthy place in the name of Jesus. This is your season to step into the Lord's abundance in the name of Jesus. You don't forget about your troubles, for the end date is being set in the name of Jesus. All you need to do at this season is to rejoice. God wouldn't have allowed it to happen if it didn't have the end date to hit. And I'm saying to you this morning, I'm saying to you categorically, that the end date to those troubles, to those illnesses, is being set. And you will say, God is not just bringing you out, he's bringing you out into a wealthy place. All you need to do, all God needs from you, is just to rejoice. It's just to rejoice and celebrate it. I just want you to join me this morning. Say, Father, I thank you for my struggle. I thank you for my loneliness. I thank you for my health issue. I thank you for every trouble I'm going through. I give you all the praise. I thank you for my dark moments right now, for I know I'm walking out. I know I'm stepping out into a wealthy place in the name of Jesus. I thank you for allowing me to go through what I've gone through. I thank you for allowing me to go through what I'm going through right now. For I know you're bringing me out with great substances in the name of Jesus. Why not celebrate God this morning? Why not celebrate Jesus for encouraging us again this morning, that we adore your holy name? For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. I prophesy into your lives today, go and prosper. Go and do well in life. Go and make impact in life in the name of Jesus. I pray for you. The grace to stay in faith is upon you this morning in the name of Jesus. The grace to dream high. The grace to have great expectations is upon you in the name of Jesus. And peradventure, you've been listening to me, you don't have a connection with this God, and you're thinking, what's she talking about? And you just want to give it a try. You want to have a relationship. You know, I always say this, we can't force you to be saved. But you've got to willingly say, yes, I want to be saved. If you're willingly saying that this morning, I just want to say this prayer with me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for your word I've heard this morning. I surrender myself to you, that it take hold of my life. In the name of Jesus, I rely so much on you. I need a relationship with you. I want you to be the author and the finisher of my faith in Jesus' name. You know, the moment you said that prayer, angels started to rejoice on your behalf. Even God is so happy on your behalf. And I celebrate you this morning. All you need to do is just to get a Bible-believing church and begin to serve God like it. It is well with your souls in the name of Jesus. Go and rejoice. I want to say this to you. Please join us. Join us on Saturday morning, 6 a.m. We'll be praying. Amen? We'll be praying. You know, God says we should pray until our joy is full. So join me by 6 a.m. on Saturday for prayer. Go and prosper. Go and succeed. And go and do well in life. I'm waiting for your testimonies in Jesus' name. God bless you all. Amen.